Yeah, now let's start lecture 19.
예수 그리스도의 부활.
Yeah, the title is Resurrection of Jesus Christ.
한번 성경 한번 읽어볼까요?
Yeah, let's look at the scripture first.
고린도전서 15장
Corinthians
3절에
chapter 15, verse 3 to 5.
내가 받은 것을 먼저 너에게 전하노니 이는 성경대로 그리스도께서 우리의 죄를 위하여 죽으시고 장사 지낸 바 되었다가 성경대로 사흘 만에 다시 살아나사 성경대로가 말씀의 예언대로 두 번이나 이렇게 나오죠.
Yeah, it says like this. For what I received, I passed on to you as of first importance. That Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. It says, according to the scriptures, it means that it, as it was prophesied.
제가 어렸을 때 성경 읽으면서 예수님의 부활은 그냥 어떤 능력으로만 비춰졌지 부활에 대해서 잘 저는 이해를 잘 못했었어요.
When I was young, as I was reading the Bible, when I just thought about this like resurrection, I just thought that maybe it is just about the power of Christ, but I couldn't realistically think of this resurrection as the real thing.
왜 부활하셔야 되는지 그 부분이 확 열하게 되게 와닿지가 않았었죠.
Like, why did he have to resurrect? I couldn't really realistically realize the reason.
과거에 제가 이렇게 기도문을 써놓은 걸 보면은 나를 위해 부활하셔서 사망 권세를 이기신 예수 그리스도.
Then before I wrote down my prayer in text like this, Jesus Christ who resurrected for me and who like overcame the power of the force of darkness. The authority of the force of darkness.
사망 권세, 예, 사단의 권세인 사망 권세를 깨뜨리고 부활하신 예수님. 결국 이 부활은 우리와 연관이 있죠. 왜냐,
so,
첫 열매.
Jesus Christ who broke down the authority of death and then resurrected. So it means that this resurrection has something to do with us. Why? Because this resurrection is the first fruit.
예수님처럼 우리도 부활해서 심판대 앞에 설 것이고요.
We will also resurrect like Jesus, and then we will also stand before God to be judged.
그리스도를 믿는 그 언약 통해서 우리는 영원한 천국에 들어가겠죠.
And through the covenant to believe in Christ, we will enter into eternal heaven.
그래서 부활은 과거에는 막 이렇게 부활절을 굉장히 같이 고통받는 거에 포인트를 맞췄다 그러면은 지금은 그렇게 생각 안 해. 너무 기쁜 날이에요.
In the past, when we let me check this one. In the past, like when you just thought about the day when Jesus resurrected, we thought that Jesus he really like suffered a lot. And that is why many people, they just wanted to like commemorate that day. But now, like after realizing this gospel, actually the day that Jesus resurrected, it is really like happy moment for us.
그래서 나를 위해서 부활하셨다는 이 부분을 우리는 붙잡아야 되겠죠.
So that is why we have to grab hold of this fact. Oh, he resurrected for me.
네, 그 유인물 보겠습니다.
And now let's have a look at this material.
부활을 처음에는 아무도 믿지 않았다.
Number one, at first, no one believed the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
제자들조차 믿지 않았기 때문에 다 도망하였죠.
But even disciples, they didn't believe in this. That is why they all ran away.
그 예수님의 은총을 받은 마리아조차도 무덤에 갈 때 부활하신 예수님을 맞으러 간 게 아니라 시체, 죽은 사람을 위한 어떤 물품을 가지고 갔지요.
Even Mary, who received kind of mercy, who had the mercy from God, when she went to the like tomb, actually she didn't really just go there to see the resurrection of Jesus Christ, but she just also brought some like oil, which is the like something for the dead corpse, for the like dead body.
베드로는 부활 소식을 듣고도 물고기 잡으러 갔어요.
And what about like Peter? After he heard that Jesus resurrected, he just went back fishing.
그래서 제가 아까 얘기했듯이 사복음서에서의 베드로와 제자들의 모습과 사도행전에서의 제자들의 모습은 다르다고 얘기한 부분이죠.
So like when I started this lecture, I told you that like the Peter from the four different books, like Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And yeah, the Peter from those four books and the Peter from the book of Acts. And not only Peter and other disciples, they look totally different.
믿음이 연약해서 과거로 되돌아갔지만 예수님은 찾아가셔서 다시 사명을 깨워주시죠.
And back then, like, his faith was really weak, and that is why he went back to his like his past. But Jesus, he visited him again, so that like he kind of reminded his commission.
왜 그들이 믿지 않았을까요?
What is the reason that they didn't believe?
네, 사람은 부활할 수 없기 때문에.
Why? Because like man cannot resurrect.
또 예수님은 십자가상에서 완벽하게 죽으셨기 때문에.
And also like Jesus, he died completely on the cross.
네. 예수님이 하나님인 것을 아는 자가 없었기 때문에.
And why? Because no one really knew that Jesus was God.
네. 또 과학적, 의학적, 생리적으로 인간은 죽었다 부활할 수가 없거든요. 불가능하기 때문에.
And also like scientifically and medically and biologically, like if man dies and just resurrect, it is actually, it makes no sense. It is impossible. That is why no one believed in this.
그러나 예수님은 오늘 우리가 읽었던 성경 본문처럼 성경대로 예언의 말씀대로 부활하셨어요.
But as we read the like scripture today, like as it was written in the Bible, according to the scripture, he resurrected. He rose again.
어떻게 부활하셨을까요? 그는 하나님이시기 때문에.
How did he rise again? Why? Because he is God.
그래서 예수님은 100% 사람이며 또 100% 하나님이세요.
That is why you can say that Jesus, he is he's a man for 100% and also he is God for 100%.
그리고 예수님의 부활은 아까도 말씀드렸다시피 우리도 부활하는 그 첫 열매로 문을 열어 놓으신 거죠.
And then as I mentioned before, like we will also resurrect later. And as the first fruit, he opened the door as a first fruit.
부활은 기독교 신앙의 교리 중에서 굉장히 중요하죠.
So when it comes to the like doctrine of Christianity, this resurrection, it is really important.
그래서 부활이 없다 그러면은 예수 믿는 사람들이 가장 불쌍한 사람이라고까지 표현했어요.
And that is why some people say like this, if there is no resurrection in Christianity, then those people who believe in Jesus, they are the kind of poor people ever.
그래서 바울은 사도행전 17장 2절에서 3절에서 보면은 예수님이 부활했다 그 정도가 아니라 부활하셔야 되는 그 당위성을 증거했죠.
And that is why if you look at Acts chapter 17 verse 2 to 3, Paul didn't just like say that Jesus had resurrected, but he testified the reason why he should resurrect.
네. 예수님의 부활을 유대인들은 어떻게 조작했는가?
But how did Jews manipulate a resurrection of Jesus Christ?
네. 죽은 줄 알았더니 기절했다가 깨났다 해서 기절설을 주장했어요.
And they thought that oh, the Jesus he surely died, but maybe he just fainted and then just like resurrected, and that is why they made this theory, like theory of being faint.
도난설은 죽은 시체가 있어야 되는데 시체가 없어졌다는 것을 말씀 얘기하고 있는 부분이에요.
And then there is also a theory of being stolen. It means that if someone dies, then there must be the like corpse there, but his corpse was not there. It was gone. So it means that the flesh itself was surely gone.
세 번째 환상설은 아 죽은 사람이 살아서 보였다는 얘기거든요.
And then also the small number three theory of illusion. It means that some people they surely like saw that person like and after his death he was like moving. So it means that like, they surely really saw that the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
그러니까 유대인들이 얘기하는 기절설, 도난설, 환상설은 그 자체가 예수님의 부활을 증명하고 있죠.
So those three theories, like theory of being fainted, and then theory of being stolen, and the theory of illusion, all these theories actually like they explain that Jesus he surely rose again.
제가 청년부 시절에 그 빌라도의 보고서라는 걸 어디서 누가 가져와가지고 그거를 나사에서 조사한 그 프로젝트나 어떤 프로그램을 보면서 철하에 그때 저기 그때 우름바다로 변하면서 그렇게 거의 부흥회처럼 이렇게 했던 기억이 있어요.
When I was a young adult, someone like brought me kind of a book or something about which is called a report of Pilate. And then like we all like saw that one and then like all the like young adults in the church we actually really cried a lot because it explained about the death of Jesus Christ.
근데 아마 인터넷에 찾으면 아마 그거 나올 거예요. 빌라도 총독의 보고서라는 게 있어요.
Oh, yes. Maybe like you can find out that like in that video clip which is called the report of Pilate.
그거 보면은 빌라도가 고민하면서 예수의 그 부활에 대한 부분을 쭉 로마 황제에게 보고서를 기록한 그 있거든요. 굉장히 like... 그 리얼하더라고.
It's kind of a movie, and then if you look at the movie, if you watch the movie, then actually it tells us about the like the Pilate, and then after Jesus died and resurrected, the Pilate he kind of thought about this resurrection a lot, and then he made a report to the like emperor, the Roman emperor, and then he just like made out the report really detail. So if you look at that movie, if you watch the movie, like you can see. All the things about the resurrection and death of Jesus Christ for real.
복사해가지고 렘넌트들에게 보여주면 굉장히 또 유익한 어떤 부분이더라고.
Oh yeah, I think it'd be really like useful to show our remnants.
예수께서 죽은 자 가운데서 부활하신 네 가지 증거. 첫 번째가 예언된 사건이다.
Yeah. Now like we can see that. Number five, it says the four evidences that Jesus resurrected among the dead. And the first, small number one, it was prophesied.
뭐 꼭 저 보지 않고도 믿어져야 되는데 그 제가 예전에 청년부 시절에 본 거 보니까 나사가 그 예수님 아리마대 요셉이 덮었던 세마포 있잖아요. 그거를 이렇게 레이저로 이렇게 옛날 그 흔적을 찾아가지고 그 이렇게 저기 못 박은 자국 피 이렇게 저기 한 이런 게 형상이 이렇게 어렴풋이 나오더라고요. 보니까 굉장히 리얼한 어떤 부분이 있더라고요.
Yeah, of course. Like we must be, really believe in this without like seeing the evidence. But like when I was a young adult, I also like saw some like video clip and the NASA they kind of they kind of like made a research about the like linen cloth which covered the corpse of Jesus Christ, the dead body of Jesus Christ, and then like, through the razor they kind of figured out that there was some blood on the linen cloth, and through that they kind of figured out like how Jesus kind of looked like when he was alive or something. And then when I was watching that movie, it really kind of felt like real.
한번 찾아보세요.
So maybe like if you are interested, you can also like try to find out from the internet.
성경에 예언된 사건이고요.
Yeah, so it was all like prophesized in the Bible.
네. 또 이제 빈 무덤이 증거하고 있고요.
And also like Jesus' empty tomb testifies about his resurrection.
또 본 사람이 증거하고 있고요.
And then those who saw him, they also testified.
제가 인도라든지 스리랑카든지 이렇게 해외 사역을 가면서 그 기독교 그 문화 유적이 많이 있는 걸 봤어요.
And then when I visited like India or Sri Lanka or other countries, I saw many like cultural heritage, like Christian cultural heritage.
예수님의 열한 제자들이 거의 다 순교했더라고요. 근데 전 세계에 흩어져서 복음 전파하고 순교했더라고요.
And the like 11 disciples of Jesus, they like almost everyone, they were martyred. And then actually they were just spread to all over the world and then they were martyred there.
결국은 그 사람들이 생을 걸고 순교하면서까지 복음을 전할 수 있었던 거는 3년 동안 예수님과 함께하며 또 감람산을 통해서 예수가 그리스도 맞구나 하는 그 결론을 답을 가졌기 때문에 그럴 수가 있었다고 봐야죠.
Yeah, for those disciples, they risked their lives and then they really followed Jesus Christ. Why? Because for 3 years they were following Jesus in Mount Olive and everywhere, and then they really saw the fact that Jesus was the Christ, and that is why they had no choice but to like risk their life and that they really stake their life.
그리고 또 성령으로 지금 우리와 함께 하신 그 부분을 우리가 날마다 누려야 되겠죠.
And also now he is with us through his Holy Spirit. So every day we must be able to enjoy this fact.
성경 한 군데 또 더 찾아보겠습니다.
And let's have a look at one more Bible verse.
복음에 대해서 설명한 것이 있어요. 복음은 하고선 복음에 대한 설명.
And there are some Bible verses about the gospel. It starts like this. The gospel is
신약 성경 로마서
Yeah, Romans.
예, 1장 2절서부터 4절이 복음에 대한 설명이거든요. 그리스도에 대한 설명.
If you look at Romans chapter 1, verse 2 to 4, it explains about the gospel, about the Christ.
제가 신학교 다닐 때 이거를 암송해가지고 성경구사 치고 그랬거든요.
When I was like studying in the seminary school, I had to memorize these Bible verses and then
2절부터 4절까지 보겠습니다. 합독하겠습니다.
Let's have a look at this.
The gospel he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures.
Regarding his son, who as to his human nature was a descendant of David.
마태복음 1장에 보면 아브라함과 다윗의 자손 예수 그리스도의 세계라고 말씀하고 있잖아요.
If you look at Matthew chapter 1 verse 1, it says that it says like this. It says that a record of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham.
또 4절에 보면은 성결의 영으로는 죽은 자들 가운데서 부활하사 능력으로 하나님의 아들로 선포되셨으니 곧 우리 주 예수 그리스도시니라.
And also verse 4 says that and who through the spirit of holiness was declared with power to be the son of God by his resurrection from the dead. Jesus Christ our Lord.
네. 능력으로 하나님의 아들로 인정받았고요.
It means that with power he was like recognized as a 네. son of God.
그래서 그리스도는 바로 하나님이시기도 하고요.
And that is why Christ he is same as God.
그래서 예수님도 하나로 얘기도 하고 둘로 얘기를 하기도 하고 나를 본 자는 아버지를 봤다 얘기 했잖아요.
And that is what Jesus also explained about him, like with a singular form or sometimes like plural form. Like he sometimes says like this: "Those who saw me also saw Father God."
나를 본 자는 아버지를 봤다고 얘기도 하셨고요.
Yeah, he said like this: "Those who saw me also saw the Father God."
네, 나와 아버지는 하나라 그러니까 유대인들이 돌을 들어서 치려고 했었잖아요.
And also just said, I and my father are one. And because of that, the Jews, they wanted to stone him to death.
근데 창세기 1장 26절에 보면은 우리가 우리의 형상을 따라 우리의 모양대로 우리가 사람을 만들고 복수로 얘기하고 있는 걸 볼 수 있어요.
But if you look at Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, God says like this, let us make man. So he, God used this plural form.
요한복음 1장도 한번 보겠습니다.
And let's also have a look at John chapter 1.
1장 1절부터요.
Yeah, John chapter 1 verse 1.
자, 만물이 3절에 만물이 그로 말미암아 지은 바 되었으니 그러니까 창조 사역에서도 예수님은 함께 창조를 했다는 얘기예요.
John chapter 1 verse 3 says through him all things were made. It means that when it comes to the like creation ministry, Jesus was there too. He was also with he was also there and he also was a part of the creation ministry.
내가 신학자가 아니기 때문에 확연하게 얘기할 수는 없지만은 창조 사역하실 때는 아마 영으로 계시지 않았나 생각됩니다.
Yeah, I'm not a like a theological like theologian, and that is why I cannot really say this for sure. But maybe when it comes to the creation ministry, maybe Jesus was there through the Spirit.
또 예수님은 뭐라 그랬어요?
And what did Jesus say?
내 이름으로 보내실 성령.
It says that the Holy Spirit that God will send in my name.
그러니까 내 안에 지금 어떻게 해요? 육신으로 계시는 게 아니라 성령으로 내 안에 계시죠.
So does that mean? And right now, like he is not really with me together with his flesh, but through the Spirit, he is inside of me.
하늘과 땅의 모든 것에 누구에게 있어요? 원래 하나님께 있는 부분이에요.
Actually, like all the authority of heaven and the earth belongs to God originally, right?
또 내게 주신 그 능력이라고도 말씀하셨고요.
But Jesus also said that the power that God gave to me.
그래서 성경은 삼위일체 부분을 아주 선명하게 이해 쉽게 계속 말하고 말씀하고 있어요.
And that is why the Bible keeps telling us about this triune God or the Trinity so that we can easily understand.
굳이 신학적으로 누가 이렇게 따져보면은 구원을 설명하는 부분에서 그 정도만 설명하고 넘어가는 게 좋겠죠.
So like if someone wants to like ask us some question about this Trinity or like triune God, then you can just explain to them from the perspective of this salvation.
그래서 기독교 교리는 두리뭉실한 게 아니라 굉장히 선명하고 조직적이에요.
And that is why like the Christian doctrine, it is not really like kind of random or like vague thing, but it is really like organized and it is really clear.
논리적이고요.
It is really logical.
합리적이고요.
And it is also really rational.
성 육신, 성령으로 육신을 입고 이 땅에 오셔야 되고요.
Like incarnation, it means that the Spirit, Holy Spirit, it must become flesh and then came down to this earth.
두 번째, 정령이 인류의 모든 죄, 내 죄를 위해서 십자가에서 죽으셔야 되고요.
And second, like for my sin, for all mankind's sin, he should die on the cross.
우리가 천국 들어가기 위해서 부활의 첫 열매로 부활하셔야 되고요.
So in order for us to enter into the heaven, like as the first fruit of resurrection, he must rise again.
그리고 성령으로 많은 사람에게 동시 사역을 하기 위해서 하늘로 승천하시고 성령을 보내셨잖아요.
And then like he has to really like work up on everyone simultaneously, and that is why he ascended into heaven and then came down to this earth. He sent God, Father God sent the Holy Spirit to this earth.
아직까지 이루어지지 않은 마지막 다섯 번째 재림 다시 오셔서 다시 오실 때 예수님이 부활한 것처럼 자는 자 먼저 죽은 자들 다 새 옷을 입고 부활해서 예수님 앞에 심판대에
And the fifth thing, which is not really fulfilled yet, it is the second coming of Jesus Christ. When Jesus would come to this earth again, at that time, all the people who died, and as if they were sleeping, they were all waking up. They will all like resurrect. Then they'll like put the new cloth, the white cloth, and then they'll stand before God, and then they will be judged.
네. 예수님 앞에서 하나님의 백성으로 판정받은 그 모든 하나님의 백성과 예수님이 천국으로 들림 받는다 그러죠.
And then like we also say that like with Jesus, like all people who are recognized as the children of God, as the people of God, and they will go to the heaven together to God.
그 속에서 영원히 예수님과 함께 천국에서 영원한 삶이 있는 거죠.
And then with Jesus together, like we can enjoy this eternal life there in the heaven.
그러니까 기독교 교리는 굉장히 완벽해요.
That is how you can say that from this like Trinity, this triune God, this Christian doctrine is really like perfect and organized and like complete.
그래서 공부 좀 했다는 사람이 논리적으로 질문해도 다 답을 줄 수 있는 부분이에요.
And that is like even though like kind of smart or like clever people would ask some questions about our doctrines, we can like answer to their question.
마지막 20과
And now let's have a look at the last lecture, the lecture last chapter, lecture 12, lecture 20.
네, 우리 속에 계신 예수 그리스도.
Jesus Christ in us.
계시록 3장 20절 말씀 보겠습니다.
Now let's have a look at Revelation chapter 3 verse 20 together.
요한계시록 네, 이거는 거의 다 암기하고 있습니다. 골지어다 내가 문 밖에
Here I am. I stand at the door and knock.
내 음성을 듣고
If anyone hears my voice, opens the door, I'll come in and you with him, and he with me.
네. 또 이 말씀을 또 연결해 주는 부분이 고린도전서 3장 16절이죠.
And also, like, there is another Bible verse which is related to this word. This one, this is First Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16.
우리 안에 성령이
and the Holy Spirit who is in us.
그리고 창세기 2장 7절에도 하나님이 땅의 흙으로 사람을 지으시고 그 코에 생기를 불어넣으시니 사람이 생명이 된지라.
And if you look at Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, it says that the Lord God formed the man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being.
홍수 멸망 시대에 창세기 6장 2절에 보면은 하나님의 아들들이 사람의 딸들의 아름다움을 보고 자기들이 좋아하는 여자로 아내를 삼는지라 이렇게 말하고 있어요.
In the time of Nephilim, if you look at Genesis chapter 6 verse 2, it says like this. The sons of God saw that the daughters of men were beautiful, and they married any of them they chose.
많은 사람들이 배우자를 택할 때 하나님께 묻지 아니하고 자기가 좋아하는 여자로 아내를 삼죠.
When many people like choose their spouse, they didn't really, they don't really ask God about their spouse, but they just like chose the one that they like.
결혼은 굉장히 중요합니다.
Marriage is really, really important.
인간을 창조하고서는 생육하고 번성하라 그랬어요. 물론 육적인 것도 포함되지만 영적인 부분이 더 큰데 결혼은 굉장히 중요한데 하나님이 짝지어준 사람과 결혼하는 게 아니라 내가 하나님 돼서 내 마음대로 내가 선택하는 자로 아내를 삼지요.
Like after creating a man, of course God said to mankind that be fruitful and increase in number, fill the earth and subdue it. Well, of course it is also about the like physical. It also has the physical meaning, but there is like spiritual meaning behind it, and the thing is, when like men choose their spouse, actually they have to get married to someone that God appointed, but they, but many in many cases people do not really care about that, but they just like want to choose some people, choose a person that they just like. It means that they themselves become kind of God. It's all like self-centered.
이걸 왜 이렇게 강조하냐?
What is the reason that I emphasize on this a lot?
그 결과가 어떻게 되냐?
Because what happened?
6장 3절에 보면은 나의 신이 영원히 사람과 함께 하지 아니하리니 그들이 육체가 됨이니라.
Because the result of the fact that they just chose the person that they like is this. The verse 3, it says, Genesis chapter 6, verse 3, it says, Then the Lord said, My spirit will not contend with man forever, for he is mortal.
결국 어떻게 돼요? 매필이 임하고 하나님이 세상을 보면서 근심하고 한탄할 정도로 죄악이 관영한 것을 볼 수 있어요.
So what happened? The age of Nephilim came, and then verse 5 and 6 it says that the Lord was grieved, and he really like resented, right? And because the sin, the wickedness of like man was really filled on this earth.
그러니까 우리가 하나님을 바라보고 하나님께 질문하고 하나님께 기도하고 이런 어떤 행위가 하나님 바라보는 행위가 우리 안에 계신 성령이 역동적으로 활동할 수 있는 어떤 그런 부분이 된다는 부분이죠.
And that is why like asking God and looking at God and like praying to God. And if you just do so, then the Holy Spirit who is inside of us, and when you just do it at that time, like the Holy Spirit will just kind of work actively.
그러니까 성령의 역사가 이렇게 빈번하게 역동적으로 활성화하기 위해서 하나님 바라보고 예배하고 기도하고 하나님을 즐거워하는 어떤 그런 모든 부분이 결국 그렇게 된다는 부분이에요.
And that is why, like, for the Holy Spirit will work actively inside of us, we really have to like worship God, pray to God, and then like look for God.
신명기인가요? 이사야 43장 21절인가에 이 백성은 내가 나를 위하여 지었나니 나를 찬송하게 하려 함이니라.
If you look at Isaiah chapter 43 verse 21, it says like the people I formed for myself that they may proclaim my praise.
다윗이 여호와를 많이 찬양했죠.
David He praised Jehovah God a lot.
복 있는 자는 여호와의 말씀을 즐거워하여 그 말씀을 주의하여 묵상하는 자라고 또 얘기했지만은 뭘 얘기하려고 이렇게 길게 얘기하냐? 결국 계시록 3장에서 20절에서 얘기하는 주님 안에 내가 있고 내가 주님 이렇게 교제하는 것이 굉장히 중요하다는 것을 얘기하는 부분이에요.
And then also like David also confessed like this, but his delight is in the law of the Lord and on his law, he meditates day and night. And if you also look at Revelation chapter 3, verse 20, like he is in me and that I am in him. So like communicating with him, that is really important.
누구든지 내 음성을 듣고 문을 열면 내가 그에게로 들어가 그로 더불어 먹고 그는 나와 더불어 먹으리라.
And yeah, Revelation chapter 3 verse 20 says that here I am, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with him and he with me.
그러니까 하나님과의 교제, 그리스도와의 교제가 너무너무 중요하다는 것을 내가 얘기하는 부분이죠.
And that is why like having fellowship with God, like with Christ, that is really important.
네. 제가 이 저기 유인물대로 쭉 하는 게 아니라 이건 읽어봐도 되고 결국 우리가 현장에서 복음 전할 때 성경 말씀을 읽어주고 그 말씀을 통해서 복음을 증거하는 것이 굉장히 중요해요.
And actually, I'm not really just giving the lecture according to this like the order in the material, but like when you really share the word or the message in the field, you really have to just read this like scripture one by one and then just like share it as it is to others. But like before that, like making this material, the content as yours and share this to others, that is really important.
유 목사님이 복음을 설명하는 구절 30개가 내 것이 되고 나니까 많은 역사가 일어났다고 얘기를 하시잖아요.
Reverend Liu, he often says like this, there are 30 Bible verses which explain about the gospel. And he really made these 30 verses as his own things. And after that, like everything, really many works took place for him.
네. 구원의 길, 복음 선구 49절. 요거는 다 암송이 되어져야 되겠죠.
There are like 40 Bible verses related to the way of salvation. You must really memorize all of them.
제 경우 영성학교라는 어떤 치유 프로그램을 진행하면서 계속 이거를 녹취하다 보니까 그냥 암송이 되어졌어요.
In my case, like we had a spirituality school, which is related to the, like healing. When we just ran that like program, the healing program, and we often like wrote down all the Bible verses one by one related to this way of salvation, and I happened to memorize all these Bible verses.
근데 이것이 현장에서 복음 없어 힘들어하는 사람에게 복음 전할 때 굉장히 성령의 능력으로 선포가 되어지더라고요.
And then when I really share this gospel to the people like who are really suffering because they don't have the gospel, and then like when I really share this message, this like memorized Bible verses to them at the time, the word really like was proclaimed with the power of the Holy Spirit.
교재 잠깐 보겠습니다.
And now let's have a look at the lecture material once again.
네. 고린도후서 4장 4절도 중요하죠. 왜냐? 이 세상 신이 믿지 않는 자의 마음을 혼미케 하여 이런 것이 보여야 아 그리스도 아니면 안 되는구나 하는 것도 발견되겠죠.
Yeah, like number one and a small number one. It says about this. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, it says, the God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers. So you also have to really see that there is this like Satan who really like confuses the mind of unbelievers.
데살로니가후서 2장 9절에서 10절도 왜 항상 기뻐해요? 성령이 나와 함께 하시니까. 네, 그리고 또 현장에 흑암이 없어 하니까. 네. 우리는 빛을 비추는 너희는 빛이라 그랬잖아요. 이사야 60장에도.
And also like 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 9 to 10. And the reason why we have to really be joyful all the time is because of course there is the work of Satan, and then but still like God is with us. And then yeah, like, since like that God is with us, since because of the fact that God is with us, we have to be like happy and then joyful all the time.
고린도후서 11장 14절에도 광명의 천사로 미혹한다 그러는데 아담이 창세기 2장 17절에 대한 답을 가지고 있었으면은 흑암이 감히 못 하죠.
And also 2 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 14 it says like this. And no wonder, for Satan himself masquerades as an angel of light. And in the case of Adam, like if Adam had really had the answer about Genesis chapter 2 verse 17, then like how could Satan really try to like lure or deceive Adam?
그래서 우리 교단은 말씀을 많이 강조하는 게 그러니까 말씀을 통해서 하나님과의 교제 부분이 되어져야 되겠죠.
So our denomination really emphasized on the word of God, right? So it means that like through the word of God, like we must have the fellowship or the communication with God.
왜두 번째 왜 그리스도와의 교제가 끊어지는가?
And number two, why is communion with Christ cut off?
물론 뭐 말씀을 듣고 행치 않을 때라고 얘기하고 있는데 진짜 영적이 말씀으로 내가 묵상하면서 은혜 받는 것에 시스템이 없으면은 지속이 안 돼요.
And number one, it says that when you hear the word and not act, it says like this. But like if you don't really have the spiritual system, then you cannot really have communication with God, and also you cannot really have continuation.
제 경우에 있어서 너무 어떻게 힘든 일이 이렇게 닥쳐왔으면은 저는 조용히 앉아서 그 49절 이미 내 머릿속에 다 있으니까 녹취를 시작을 합니다.
And when some hard problems like come to me, then I just like sit down, I just like sit still, and then I start to just write down all the like 40 Bible verses which are in my mind already.
내가 그것을 안 하면은 생각이 환경에 잡히고 문제에 사로잡히고 행복하지 않아요.
Because if I don't do this, then my thought are all captured by environment, by circumstances, and by problems. So I cannot really feel happy. I cannot really enjoy this happiness.
근데 그 녹취를 쭉 하다 보면은 베드로전서 5장 7절에서 9절. 너희 염려를 다 주께 맡기라. 이는 그가 너희를 돌보심이라.
But when I just start to just write down all the Bible verses, all the 40 Bible verses, then as it is written in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7 to 8, it says, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you.
네, 그걸 기록하다 보면 그래 말이야. 왜 내가 염려하냐? 하나님이 나를 돌보고 계시는데 이렇게 깨달아지면서 위로가 되고 그래 말이야. 그래 말이야. 이렇게 되더라고요.
So just when I start to write down all these like 40 Bible verses on my own, then my thought starts to change. Like, oh, right. Like it says that cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Oh, that's right. If that is so, then why should I worry? Why should I be captured by these problems? Oh, that's right. That's really right.
그래서 계속 쓰다 보면은 문제가 사라지고 나가서 앞집, 집, 뒷집 이런 데 전도하고 싶더라니까요.
And that is when I start to write down all these Bible verses, then all my worries and problems just like are gone. And then I just want to like visit my neighborhood, and then just I really have the heart to evangelize them.
복음으로 행복해야 전도하고 싶어집니다.
Like first of all, you should be happy because of this gospel. Only then can you have the heart to evangelize others.
빌립보서에서도 예. 너의 마음과 생각을 지키시라 그랬잖아요.
If you look at Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 to 7, it also says that the peace of God which transcends all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
예, 요한복음 15장 4절 5절에도 예. 포도나무 가지가 줄기에 붙어 있는 것처럼 예, 붙어 있기만 하면은 예, 붙어 있는 어떤 이런 부분을 우리가 그냥 말로만 하는 게 해서는 안 되겠죠.
And also, as it is written in John chapter 15, verse 4 to 5, it says that once the branch is this branch remains in the vine. So it means that we will have to focus on this. Like, what is the meaning of being remained in this vine?
갈라디아서 5장 16절에서 17절에서 성령을 쫓지 않고 육체의 욕심을 쫓을 때라 그랬는데. 내가 진짜 복음으로 또 하나님 자녀의 신분과 권세를 행복하면은 내가 초청 안 해도 성령이 충만하게 역사하고요. 육체의 욕심은 사라지게 돼 있어요.
And if you look at Galatians chapter 5 verse 16 to 17, it says that like live by the Spirit and you will not gratify the desires of the sinful nature. So it means that like if you are really filled by this Holy Spirit, then even though you don't really like chase after the like physical thing or like worldly thing, but they have no choice but to just follow you.
뭐 3번은 어떻게 그리스도를 우리 속에 역사하여 나타나시는 체험할 수 있는가? 하나님 자녀야 체험되겠죠.
Number three, how can you experience Christ's work and manifestation in us? And of course, we have to become children of God first, then we can experience other things.
첫 번째 이벤트가 영접이라고 그러면은 진짜 중요한 두 번째 이벤트는 주인으로 모시는 것이겠죠.
So the first important event, it is like accepting Christ instead of us. And then the second event, the second important thing is we have to really accept that Christ as your master, as your Lord.
네. 그리스도께서 우리 속에 나타내시어 인도하시고 능력 나타내기를 원한다. 결국 나와 함께함의 이 동거의 비밀이 날마다 깨달아지고 응답되어지고 그래서 증인으로 서야 되겠죠.
And so number three, you should believe that Christ appears in us, guides us, and wants to show his power. So it means that like ultimately, like you really have to endure the mystery of God being with you. Like only then can you really can you really like show the evidence as witnesses, as witness 네. of Christ?
네, 베드로전서 5장 7절에서 8절은 아까 제가 말씀드렸고요.
Yeah, I mentioned already about 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7 to 8.
네, 고린도후서 5장 17절은 그런즉 누구든지 그리스도 안에 있으면은 새로운 피조물이라. 그리스도 안에 있다는 것에 대해서 우리가 깊이 묵상해야 되겠죠.
And then 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17, it says like this, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. So you have to really meditate upon this fact deeply. If anyone is in Christ, about in Christ.
나를 십자가에 못 박아야 된다. 갈라디아서 2장 20절을 놓고 뭐 이렇게 하려고 하는 사람이 있어요. 근데 하려고가 아니라 저기 원숭이를 잡는 사람이 그 저기 유튜브에 보니까 있더라고요.
In
원숭이 잡는 거.
About Galatians chapter 2 verse 20. It says that you should crucify yourself on the cross. And then about this Galatians chapter 2 verse 20. Many people, they interpret this like this. You should do something maybe, but actually I saw one like video clip from the YouTube. There was a person who wants to capture, who wants to like catch monkeys.
그 저기 맛있는 걸 이렇게 먹다가 이렇게 손 이렇게 손이 들어갈 만한 그 구멍에다가 그걸 집어넣고서는 자리를 비운대요.
And then like this is his way to catches to catch like monkeys. Like he eats something really delicious and then he just put this like delicious food inside of one like kind of shell. And he just like put this like food into this like into this hole and then he just leaves.
호기심이 많은 원숭이가 외로워 가지고 손을 이렇게 집어넣어 가지고 안에 물건을 잡는데 잡으면은 손이 안 빠지잖아요.
So this monkey, like who is really curious, like he wants to, of course, like have this delicious food inside of the hole. So he just like puts his hand into this like hole and he grabs hold of that food, right? But once he just grabs hold of this food, then he cannot really take his hand out of this hole. So like he like shouts.
그때 이제 나와가지고 그 저기 원숭이 잡는 사람이 뭐 묶기도 하고 목에다 이렇게 줄 묶기도 하고 그리고 이제 더 좋은 거를 눈앞에 딱 보여주면 그때 색을 논다는 얘기야.
And then at the time the man who wants to like catch this like monkey and they can maybe like they tie monkey with a like rope or something and then he shows something better than this food. Then only at that time this monkey he kind of like
그러니까 진짜
his this like food.
진짜 복음, 그리스도의 비밀 이게 그 가치와 넓이를 우리가 알게 되면은 갈라디아 2장 20절이 되어지겠죠.
And so what does that mean? It means that once we really know the value of this Christ, this covenant, then the Galatians chapter 2 verse 20 it'll just take place.
네, 7번 가나의 혼인 잔치 예수님이 주인 되면은 모든 게 끝이죠.
Yeah, so small number 7, like it's about the like wedding feast in Cana. Once Jesus becomes your Lord, then everything is over.
네, 쭉 읽어보시면 됩니다.
Yeah, we can just like read the rest.
내가 주 안에 거하고 주님이 내 안에 거할 때.
And number 4, when I am in the Lord and when the Lord is in me.
없어지는 것과 생겨나는 것.
And at the time, like what disappears and what appears.
그 마음의 공허함이 없어진다고 했는데 시편 23편은 다윗이 쫓김을 당할 때 고백한 그 시거든요.
And it says the emptiness of the heart is gone. And if you look at Psalm chapter 23 and it is the like kind of poem that David made when he was chased after.
우리는 저녁에 잘 데 없어가지고 걱정하거나 저녁에 먹을 거 없어서 걱정하거나 그러진 않잖아요.
Maybe like we don't really worry about where to sleep tonight or like what to eat today in the evening.
다윗은 쫓겨다니는 입장이기 때문에 그런 것이 준비가 안 돼 있었어요.
But David, like in his case, he was always like chased after by the king Saul. That is why like all these kind of things were not really prepared, were not really ready for him.
근데 뭐라고 합니까? 여호와가 나의 목자시기 때문에 내게 부족함이 없다 그랬어요. 부족함이 많지만은 부족함이 없다 그랬다고.
He says that the Lord is my shepherd; I shall not be in want. It means that actually he has many things that he really needs, but he says, "I shall not be in want."
그래서 여호수아에게도 근심하지 말라 그랬고요.
And that is why, like God said to Joshua, like this, do not worry.
네. 하나님이 함께 하십니까?
Why? Because God is with him.
네, 결국은 네, 세상이 알 수 없는 나만의 비밀 누리게 되죠.
Yeah, so it means that to that extent, you really have to enjoy your own mystery that the world cannot even realize.
그래서 우리는 신앙생활이 되어져야 되겠죠.
So like this, our walk of faith must just take place.
많은 사람이 신앙생활하기보다는 인왕생활이에요. 인왕생활.
Like in the case of many people, like rather than have the walk of faith, and actually they are like having the walk of like people.
어려운 말인데 제대로 통역했나 모르겠네. 네. 그래서 신앙생활이 되어져야 되겠죠.
Yeah, the true walk of faith should be restored.
아, 이거 가지고 설명하는 게 그렇게 길어지지가 않네. 기도할게요, 제가.
Yeah, so now let's pray.
사랑의 하나님 감사합니다.
Dear God of love, we thank you.
누구보다도 그리스도의 비밀을 제대로 누리는 자 되게 하옵소서.
And more than anyone, let us really be the ones who can really enjoy the mystery of Christ correctly.
누가 뭐래도 저희는 복 있는 자입니다.
No matter who says what, we are blessed ones.
여호와의 말씀을 즐거워하여 주야로 묵상하는 자 되게 하여 주시옵소서.
And let us really like be joyful because of the word of God so that we can meditate upon it day and night.
시냇가에 심겨진 나무처럼 든든한 보좌의 배경을 가지고 사역할 수 있도록 하나님 은혜 주시옵소서.
Like a tree which is rooted down by the riverside and having the like tremendous background of the throne of the like heaven, let us really have the walk of faith.
그리스도 되신 예수님 이름으로 기도합니다.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
한 시간 일찍 끝났는데 죄송합니다.
감사합니다.